Good evening, everybody. It is Saturday, October 27th. We are here at Tudron Field at Smith Vocational High School for some playoff NYFL action as the Blue Devil Seniors take on the Belchertown. I don't remember what their nickname is, but I'm Andrew Shelfo.
The Eagles.
Eagles. I'm joined in the booth by Rob Osberg. How are you, Rob?
Fantastic. This is playoff football. These are 7th and 8th graders. It's a beautiful fall night. The air is a little bit nippy. The field is a little bit wet. And it is an exciting time for Blue Devil football.
And we got a good crowd out here tonight, ready to see the Blue Devils take on the Eagles in some playoff action with a berth in the Super Bowl at stake, which would take place next weekend. Blue Devils are set to receive. Check to the right, check to the left, and here we go. The kick is away.
Matty Channel.
Received by Matt Channel. Look for some room on his right. Got a little bit of a seam. One guy to beat, but he's joined by his friends, and he's brought down around the 50-yard line. Not a bad run back to start the game.
Now, Matty did a nice job on that play. He waited for his blocking, and he burst ahead for about 15 yards.
And the most important thing he did there was he held on to the ball.
He did, and you know, that wasn't for sure. It looked like the Eagles were very aggressive trying to tackle the football, but Matty would have none of it. Blue Devils take over first and 10.
And this is a rematch from a game earlier in the season, probably around September, if my recollection is correct.
Yeah, and I'm sure both teams have put in a whole lot of options since then. In fact, here we go. Matty Channel usually sets up in the backfield, and he's out wide left.
Way out to the left. Osberg takes a snap. Davis up the middle. There's a big gain. Now it's a foot race. Dragged down at the 28-yard line. That's what you like to see out of this Blue Devil offense to start the game.
That's outstanding. Outstanding. You know what? Really like the play of that inside line. Great block. I didn't see who made it, but that was a huge hole. Andrew, I think you could have rolled through that hole.
I wouldn't have gained as many yards, but I would have given it a good try.
He was?
That was way in the old days. Yeah. But that's what you like to see. You're going to say, I'm going to line up, and here's my best shot against your best shot. Hand off right up the middle. Osberg in the shotgun formation now. Takes the snap. There's another handoff to Davis, looking for some room along the left.
Oh, nice.
Cuts it back up the middle. Brought down after a short gain, maybe a yard at the most.
Yeah, that play took a split second to get going. Unfortunately, the delay to get that play set allowed particularly the linebackers for the Eagles to penetrate into the backfield.
It was slow developing, that's for sure.
Yep.
So Belchertown has a little bit of beef there in their defensive line.
They do.
And the Blue Devils are
without number 59, Nick Sandoval, who apparently has a mild concussion. That's Channel.
Osberg takes a snap, hand off the Channel, looking for some room on the right-hand side. Does get through the initial line, brought down after a gain of about 7 yards. That's a solid gain.
Yeah, and thank you very much to that Eagle tackler who tossed Matty ahead for another yard and a half at the end of the play.
We'll take it any way we can get it here tonight.
It's going to bring up about a third and four here. You can feel some good energy on the Blue Devil sideline. You can feel some real good energy from that offensive line that were exploding off the line. Nice job in that last play by 72 Garbarini.
Osberg in the shotgun set again. Calls out the signals, and there's a little bit of movement.
Number 70.
Looks like they're gonna get some offensive movement here.
Yeah, that was Gorman.
That's unfortunate. I blame you for that, Rob. You were just talking about how they're clicking on all cylinders so far.
You know, they had that hard count there, and that would have been good for a first down, but apparently Gorman got a little anxious. He does have quite an assignment on the other side. Ooh, and we get a break.
They're calling offsides on the defense.
Oh, and you hear the groans from the other side, and there's groans from both of us, too, because we think we got away with one there.
But you're talking about the nice atmosphere. There's a lot of people here watching this game tonight, Rob. It's the nightcap. We had a triple header going on today, only two of the games involving Northampton teams. But it's been a good day for football so far. Let's hope it continues, and we cap it off with a victory. That brings up first and 10. The offsides gives a first down to the Blue Devils.
Look for number 33, Levins, on this play.
Osberg takes a snap. There's a hit off to Davis. Looking for some room.
I don't like that call at all.
He is stood up and dragged down.
Elijah David brought down.
And that was big number 78, who managed to catch up with him.
78, the tackle. 78.
They tried a new wrinkle there. Lined up Elijah Ride to the right. Had him come back across the formation. I think it's another one of those slow-developing plays.
Yeah. You know, I just don't quite understand the need for that. I mean, they do have some size on that line. And, you know, those plays that are slow developing gives number 78 a chance to take advantage of his advantage, which is his enormous size.
I think we want to keep 78 away from Davis as much as we can. That's a better play. Davis up the middle. There's a hole. That's a gain of about 6 yards there. And as we like to say up here in the booth, 5 yards at a time, that's fine. We'll take that.
The problem is that it brings up about a third and about 14 yards to go, though. It was positive yards, but it wasn't enough. It's still a third and long.
But it's definitely two-down territory from this point. They're going to go for it on fourth no matter what. So let's see what they got.
Yeah, we haven't attempted a field goal all year, so we don't look to see one here.
Odds of that are low. Osprey takes the snap, fakes the handoff, looking to throw. He's got a man open. Nice throw.
Incomplete.
Hit. I couldn't see who it hit. Was that to Levins? That was a good throw. He was in double coverage, but it was a nice throw, and unfortunately, didn't go the Blue Devils' way.
Yeah, I couldn't tell if Levins had a legitimate chance to make that play or not. There was definitely double coverage out there. The ball popped up. I couldn't tell from our angle whether it popped up having hit the hands of the Eagles or if it bounced off of the chest of Levins.
Looked like it bounced off the chest of Levins.
Did it?
Osberg's in the shotgun. He has two receivers out to his left. He's looking to throw again. Rolls a little bit to his left. Throws the ball up. Ball is away, and it is picked off. Now they got to get him because that is actually a good punt unless he gets too much yardage. And finally brought down at the 22-yard line.
Yeah, number 11, Osberg tried to do something that is appropriate for John Elway, but not an eighth grader. He tried to run left, throw right, all the way back, 30, 35 yards. He just doesn't have the arm strength for that throw. But the reality is it was a fourth down play. It really didn't matter. In fact, I would have argued that interception was a poor decision on the part of the Eagle, and he was lucky to get the ball back to the original line of scrimmage. He just should have knocked that down.
It certainly would have been a tough throw. It was a tough throw, and the receiver was also well covered.
It was.
But, yeah, that's not a bad punt. So now the Blue Devils will be on defense. The Belchertown Eagles are going to start on their own 20-yard line. They have two receivers to the left, two receivers to the right. Quarterback takes a snap. Here's a handoff. There's some room there. He gets through the hole. Now he's in the secondary. Runs over Osberg. Runs past Channel. Finally brought down after a healthy gain. That was Cy Carey, I believe, on the tackle. And also, I think Matt Channel was involved at the tackle at the end there.
Nice
that was a nice run, Rob. That wasn't really what I expected when I saw that formation.
Yeah, number 11, Osberg needs to do a much better job in those tackles. He got steamrolled on that play.
Well, I think that's going to be a little bit of a wake-up call for this Blue Devil defense.
First and 10, ball on the 45 for Belchertown.
45-yard line of the Blue Devils. Belchertown, quarterback calls out the signals, takes the snap. There's the handoff, and he is met. In the backfield. Jared Levins saw that play coming like he was in the huddle.
Yeah, you know, number 34 was inflicting pain on the fire play, but Levins said, not on this play. My turn to do 11 splat. You're going down from -5. Making a statement, maybe firing up the rest of that defense. Nice play by Levins.
Fine play by Levins. That brings up a 2nd and 15. Ball sits right at the 50-yard line.
Little lazy down there.
Belchertown also has a pretty tall offensive line, and they're going to look for them to kind of hide behind them a little bit. Two receivers to the left, two receivers to the right. They ran out of this formation last time, and they're going to do it again. There's a hole up the middle. He gets past the line, but then he's brought down by a bunch of Blue Devils.
Yeah, that looked like number 72, Garbarini, on that play. Garbarini. Nice play by both.
Tyreek Sanders was in on that tackle as well. It was a good team effort there. That brings up a 3rd and let's call it 13 here. I think this is a kind of a big play because if they stop him here, they're most likely going to punt.
And there's that
shotgun formation. Quarterback takes a snap. There's a handoff. Has some room to the right. It's the same back as had that big run before. So that's
much
a gain. That's
tackle.
A healthy gain. That's about a 10-9 yard gain. Now it's decision time for Belchertown. I would imagine they're going to go for it here.
Going to bring up about a 4th and 4 in.
Not only are they going to go for it, but they're going to do it no huddle. They split one receiver to the left, bunch formation, handoff right up the middle, and there's a big hole. He's got the first down, and he's still on his feet. Fumble, fallen on by Belchertown. That's still going to net them a first down. First down. That was a good choice by them. They're going to go no huddle again, keeping the Blue Devils back on their heels a little bit. They're going to try to do a substitution. Not going to happen. There's the handoff up the middle, and they're going to get a flag for having 12 men on the field. That was a nice tackle there by Tim Burnish. Yeah, there's a lot happening there, Rob.
Well, that penalty's going to be declined. They'll take the 9 yards versus the 4. for the five, but would have been awarded on the 12 men on the field penalty.
Yeah, you got to put that one on the coaches a little bit. They have to recognize that they're doing a no huddle. They're going to call it quick. You can't send someone on that late.
Oh, there was an offsetting penalty on that.
What was offsetting penalties?
So there was an illegal, must have been an illegal motion on the part of the Eagles on that play. Hold, is that what they call it?
So they call the hold on Belchertown. So that'll bring the ball back a bit. And that'll make it first and 10.
Offsetting penalty, Jeff. Thank you, Jeff.
There's the snap. There's the handoff. He runs into big Jared Levins.
Brought down by 33 Levins.
Also, there just in backup, just in case, is Tyreek Sanders. But that number 89 for Belchertown, that's someone we're going to have to keep an eye on tonight, Rob.
Yeah, they've got some nice players. They've got some good size and some good speed and some good strength. That makes for a good team.
That's a good combination. That's what you want to have, is size and speed. Makes it second and, let's call it, 12.
Brought down by 11 to 33.
And then there's a timeout on the field.
Blue Devils.
After the Blue Devil timeout, it's second and 12 for the Belchertown Eagles. They're on the Blue Devil 36-yard line. We've had a spirited first quarter so far. Quarterback takes a snap and there's a flag, and that's going to be illegal motion on Belchertown.
Yeah, I think the right end on that play, the wide receiver on the right side just jumped early.
Well, I think in their hurry to get that playoff, they just never really got set. We have seen them try to push the pace a little bit with a couple of no-huddle plays, but now they're just a little bit out of sync. That brings up a second and 16. They send one receiver to the right, one receiver to the left. Quarterback up under center. Takes the snap. There's a handoff up the middle. There's a keeper, quarterback keeper. My mistake. There's a gain of about six there. A nice game, but not on a second and 16 play. That'll bring up third and 12.
That was an interesting tackling style. Elijah Davis just jumped on his back and wrapped him up with his arms and his legs and forced him down.
He was up high. The other interesting thing to note here with the Belchertown offensive line is they're not getting down into a full down position. They're kind of keeping their hands on their knees, which allows the quarterback to hide behind them a little bit.
And they're tall, so they're hiding behind about 5'8" of a wall there. That's a big play here.
Third and 11. This is.
But they're definitely in four down territory. So
two receivers to the left, two receivers to the right. They've used this formation before, one, and they've run out of it every time. And they're going to pass. Oh, a little pass to the back. That's a smart play by the back. He wasn't, even though that was a forward pass, he wasn't sure. So he was going to try to fall down on that fumble. Quarterback had to hurry that throw because Jared Levins, who's camping out a lot in their backfield, was right in his face.
Yeah, Levins is just having his way with that right guard, the right tackle for the Eagles. Although that Blue Devils were very fortunate. Had he caught that ball cleanly, that play looked like it could have gone for a big game.
Fourth and 12, the Eagles are going to go for it. Quarterback is in the shotgun. They're using that a lot tonight. Fake the snap to the runner going across. There's the throw over the middle. Incomplete. Jasper Kessin was there just to make sure that ball didn't get into the hands of any Eagles players.
But there was single coverage all over the place out there. That was a dangerous situation for the Blue Devils. Fortunately, the throw was either a little bit ahead of the receiver or a little bit behind, or hard to tell what the pattern was, but really wasn't a threat.
I'm going to say that he rushed that a little bit because he was remembering what happened on the play before when he had Levins in his face.
You know, that's the Levins effect. Yep.
Yeah. But that's a good defensive stance by the Blue Devils.
Sure.
They're
going
to take over on their own 36-yard line. Osberg is up under center.
Looking for another quick hit inside, and there it is.
Takes the snap. There's the hand off the channel. It cuts it back up the middle. That's a gain of about 3 yards. He meets big number 78. Brad Taft is the name I hear, and he's already made a name for himself in this game. He's a good player.
Yeah, we're going to need to put a boy or two on that boy, because that boy is a boy or two all by himself.
And he's not shy.
He's not, and I watch the practice. He's not only the physical presence on this team, but he's also obviously a team leader. number 70 Gorman's going to have his hands full all day with it, all game with this guy.
Osberg in the shotgun. There's the handoff to Cy Carey. That's another one of those slow developing plays. And I think what we're seeing here is that the edges of the Belchertown defense, they have a lot of speed there. And these plays going across the middle, trying to take a long time to develop, they haven't really been effective yet.
They haven't been effective at all. And I think Coach Channel will recognize that very quickly and change the schematic. You know, Hamp has some quick slants in there. In their arsenal, they have some quick outs. They also have some quick hitting plays. I'd love to see them get into that secondary, because although the Belchertown line is very strong, I think they've got some vulnerability in the secondary.
So here's a little Wildcat formation. Elijah Davis takes the direct snap, looking for some room on the right hand side.
Speaking of getting into the secondary,
Osberg down there to give him the block. Davis sees the would-be tackler, sizes him up, and says, "Come on and try to take me down." Runs over him for another extra 5 yards.
Yeah, that was a super run by Davis. And, you know, I got to give number 11 Osberg credit. He's a quarterback, and quarterbacks usually don't like to block, but he did a real nice job staying with his man on that play. End of the
Osberg
quarter.
Did a great job of finding someone to block, and that's the end of the first quarter. Scoreless. So after a spirited first quarter, we're getting ready to begin the second quarter here. Scoreless game here so far.
Yeah, why don't I use this little break as an opportunity to thank the Northampton Youth Football Premium sponsors, the Northampton Police Relief Association, Calvin Coolidge Nursing Home, and Angelic Builders lead our sponsor lineup. They stepped up big time for this program. We all, parents, players, appreciate it.
Osberg takes the snap. There's a handoff to the up back. That's Cy Carey. That's a solid gain of 3.5-4 yards.
I like that play.
I do too. I think what we saw before is that the speed of the ends on Belchertown is almost too much at this point, so you have to kind of get them off the hunt a little bit and run it up the middle.
That's right. Gold Major sponsors include Pioneer Landscapes, MRW Connected LLC, Liquors 44, Attorney Mark A. Tanner of Bacon Wilson, PC.
Osberg up under center. He takes a snap. There's the pitch to Davis, looking for some room on the left. He cuts it up there, and look who tries to take him down from behind. Big number 78, who whiffs, but he is helped out by his friends there, number 99 and number 73.
Matt Modest, number 29.
Additional gold sponsors include Osberg and Associates, Florence Savings Bank, and World War II Club. The news! Let's try that again. In the World War II Club,
the news!
Much more better. Yeah, absolutely. Let's put a pitch in for the office.
And they're the backup sponsor tonight. Osberg up under center. He takes a snap. There's a pitch to Channel. He's got Davis in front of him. He's got some room there to the right. Nice block by Davis. Pass the first down. That's a gain of, that's about 20-yard gain. Did you see that block that Davis put on him?
Fantastic. Yeah, I mean, that was a nice, well-crafted play. Good job in the interior line, too. Nice timing on the pitch, nice timing on the run, and a great block, lead block by number 21, Davis. Hey, our blue sponsors include Collective Copies, Newman's Construction, Coggins, Real Estate Joe's, Pizza, yum, 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 the Whalen Insurance Agency, Dove Business Associates, Valley Home Improvement, the Weber and Grinnell Insurance Agency, the Blue Bonnet Diner, and Strides.
First down on the Belchertown 26. Here's the Wildcat formation. Davis takes a snap, runs to his right. He's got the edge. He's got the first down. Dragged out of bounds at about the 12-yard line.
I think we found a weak spot on the right, over on that right corner, and then that safety. And they've got it very strong on the left side of their line. There's a little bit of a soft spot over there on the right.
Well, you know, in all fairness, though, the left side of the Belchertown defensive line, in two plays in a row, first they had to deal with a block of Davis, and then they had to try to tackle him.
Yeah, I just think you found something that works, make him adjust, and then go the other way, right?
So that's another first down. First down at 10 on the 14-yard line.
There is nobody on channel on the left side, Ian. Look at the left side.
Let's
there's nobody
the
on channel.
Sees it.
He does.
There's a handoff out the middle. Davis gets through the line. That's a gain of about 6 yards. Ball came out. I don't see who has it. I think Belchertown has it.
That's going to be a Belchertown ball.
That's a terrible way to end that drive.
Don't break for them.
And Channel's having a little conversation with Osberg, too.
He was
just
uncovered.
Kind of saying, hey, take a look over my way sometimes.
Just peek.
Well, that's a sad way for a tremendous drive to
end. Very unfortunate. Very unfortunate. We couldn't see who who stripped the ball. But, you know, it's nighttime. It's a little bit slippery, and Davis might have been hurt on the play as well.
Looks like he's holding his hand there. I don't really know what the problem is. We'll have to keep an eye on that.
That's concerning both on the offensive side of the ball and on the defensive side of the ball.
So Belchertown takes over on the six-yard line. Last-minute substitutions for the Blue Devils.
Bosman, number 22.
There's the snap. There's the handoff up the left-hand side this time, number 89. He is in the secondary rather quickly, brought down after a gain of about 22-yard lines. Gorman made a nice tackle to finally bring him down.
Yeah, you know, and that's the deja factor. I mean, Gorman got in, Bosman got in real late and just wasn't ready to defend that play. Well, we also need to congratulate some family sponsors. They include the Andy Morrison family, the Mike Benedizek family, the Berensons, the Zinals, the Tudrins, and the Burnishes. Thank you all so much. And number 21, Davis, did report back into the game.
Back in the game. And this is a playoff game. This is time for the Blue Devil defense to step up. There's a snap. There's a handoff up the middle, and he is dragged down before he can gain anything. Levins, as we said, having a game from his left end spot.
Number 68, Andy Gregoshevitz was also in on that tackle. Nice play by Gregoshevitz on that play. Good team tackling there. Second and eight.
In a game that we've seen a lot of action so far. Still scoreless, however.
Yeah, this is a war.
Belchertown breaks the huddle. They send one receiver to the left, one receiver to the right. Quarterback takes the snap. There's the handoff up the middle. He's got some room on the left-hand side. Dragged down by Davis. Wow, he made him pay for the first down on that one.
That looked more like a Greco-Roman wrestling move than a football move.
It looked like that move, you know, you're down in the back and you put your foot in the belly and
flip him over.
What do
they call that? They call it judo, too. Is that a judo move? I don't know. Something in martial arts there.
My older brother always said that would be fun, but it never turned out to be fun.
I think, that couldn't have felt very good.
It really felt good for Elijah. First and 10 on the 40-yard line.
You know, this has already been a successful drive for these Eagles, though. They were pinned.
Quarterback takes a snap. He's looking to throw. He's got Levins dragging him down.
Levins.
That's a loss of six. That was good coverage by the Blue Devils that allowed Levins to track down that quarterback and drag him down for the loss.
You know, Levins is tall and he's fast, but he's also remarkably strong. I mean, he's got amazingly strong hands, and you saw it there as he just reached out and just pulled him down.
Got his big paws on him. There was no escape from there. Quarterback is rolling to his right, looking for his receiver, who was well covered, and there was nothing to do but take the hit from Levins.
You know, he tried to break that grip, and it was an iron grip.
Second and six after the first down loss. Two receivers to the left, one receiver to the right. Quarterback in the shotgun takes a snap. He's looking to throw.
The ball's incomplete. A lot of pressure.
I don't know if that was really the way they imagined it when they drew it up in the huddle, Rob.
Yeah, I'm not sure either.
Yeah, two receivers occupying the same space, and both of them missed the ball.
But he threw it right between them. Good for the field goal.
He did throw between them. It was a nice game of keep away.
You know what? Well, we're having fun. It is time to give a sincere thank you to our board of directors, but I think we're going to have a little timeout here first.
After the timeout, the Blue Devils defense is ready for whatever the Belchertown Eagles are going to throw at them. It's third and 16 to go.
So the board of directors is headed by President Hank Girard, and very much appreciate all his efforts. Vice President of the Northampton Youth Football League is Ron Berenson. Treasurer Diana Zinal, Secretary Erica LaMonica, and Register Taryn Johnson. Members include Pat Diggins, Brian Biseski, and Manfred Melcher. Thank you all so much for all of your efforts.
Belchertown sends one receiver wide to the left. They send 89 in motion. He grabs the pitch from the quarterback. He's looking for some room. He cuts it back. Cuts back. They're always hard. Osberg slips. Channel's got a chance at him. Can't bring him down. The ball is loose. Ball is loose on the field. It's fallen on by the Blue Devils. That's a little bit of luck, Rob, but we'll take it.
Channel forced a turnover. Ball pop loose and Blue Devils.
Boy, you know what? It's clearly slippery out there. You saw guys slipping. You saw guys sliding, and then that ball just slithered out.
Griffin Shaw fell on the ball, and then he was Ethan Gorman with the warm embrace to make sure that ball stayed Blue Devils' hands. That was a big play because 89 was loose in that secondary.
So that's a great drive by the Blue Devils that ended in a fumble and a big play from the Eagles that ended in a fumble.
this classy.
The score of this game could easily be one touchdown or one touchdown, and instead it's a 0-0. So Blue Devils take over first and 10 deep in their own territory.
First and 10 in their own 15, and as we know, we have running time here. So we could be getting close to the end of the first half. We'll have to see. Osberg in the shotgun. Sends Channel in motion, takes a snap. He's rolling to his right, looking to throw. He's got Channel. Oh, goes right through his hands. He may have lost that in the lights a little bit.
Wow, that was a great throw. That ball looked like it was right there.
It got in between the two defenders, and it looked to me like it was pretty close to Channel's hands. But the lighting conditions here aren't optimal.
You know, that's a play that up to this point has gone to Ryan Braden, who's not playing tonight, and that's the first time we really saw that his absence really hurt the Devils. Ryan's a very skilled receiver.
But that gives the Eagles something else to think about as Osberg's up under center. There's the handoff to, is that Channel? He's looking for some room up the middle. And everybody wants to dance with him, and they're all dragging him down. There's no gain on that play.
Number 9, Matt Channel. Looks back to the line. And that brings up third down and 10.
I'm impressed by both these teams, Rob. They're playing feisty football out there tonight. And it's fun to watch. And there is a timeout on the field. Dropped it over the front. After the timeout, the Blue Devils break the huddle. They send Channel wide to the left. Davis in the backfield. Osberg waiting for the referees to let them play. But the referees have to talk about it for a little bit. I don't know what they're checking there. But whatever it is, it's taking a long time. But that's the type of thing you want to see, Rob. You want to see the refs getting together to make sure they got it right.
Kendra, this is a big play. Blue Devils need some positive yardage here. We certainly don't want to be punting from deep in our own end zone. First down here would go a long way toward creating some room.
There's an I formation behind Osberg, Davis deep, and I imagine he's going to be the one to get it. They fake to him. Osberg's going to keep it, looking for some room on his right, stumbling, brought down after a gain of 2 yards. That was a good defensive play there by Belchertown, getting around Osberg's feet, not letting him get square to go forward. That brings up a big fourth down now. You're going to have to get a good kick here.
Yeah, they need to punt. Puts a lot of pressure on Greg Achevis to make a good snap here. Yeah, Davis has launched a few this year. Now would be a great time. And you know what? Those D-backs aren't deep enough for Davis.
Davis takes a snap. There's the kick, and it is a good kick. It is over the head of the deep back, deep receiver, I should say, and it gets a Blue Devil roll. And that's going to be touched down at the 42-yard line of the Eagles.
That is a spectacular punt by Davis there.
That's a great punt. That's exactly what you called for, Rob.
Yeah, that's about a 40-yard punt right there. Outstanding. Timing couldn't be better.
So we've seen so far that when players need to make plays, they've made them, but no one's broken into the end zone yet.
Well, it was a great drive by the Blue Devils that unfortunately ended in a turnover, and then a really strong drive by the Eagles that, fortunately for the Blue Devils, ended in a turnover.
The Blue Devils will be on defense as the Eagles take over on their own 42-yard line here at Tugent Field in Northampton. Send one receiver way wide to the right. One to the left. Now they're going to bring their receiver in motion. He's going to be exhausted by the time he gets back there.
At the 43.
Now they bring him on the line. Everybody looks okay. Quarterback takes the snap. He's going to hand off to the second back. Davis brings him down after a gain of 6.
You know what? That offensive line pushed us off the ball 4 yards on that play. If I'm the Eagles, I'm keeping it simple. You see that, and Hamp responds by bringing big old Tyreek in there.
Well, it was a well-designed play because they used number 89 as a decoy there.
Yeah.
And with that offensive line push, I think even you or I could have probably gained 3 or 4 yards on that
play. Yeah, you could have rolled the stroller for 6 yards before you got sacked.
Brings up a second and let's call it 5.5, 6 yards to go. Quarterback up under center. 89 goes in motion. There's the pitch. 89 looking for some room on the left. He's got Ooh, he made it into the secondary. He was finally brought down by Cy Carey with a nice tackle.
Now, Belchertown is winning the game at the line of scrimmage. We're going to need to find an answer for that. That's number, looks like number 34. Kesson is in the game, and along with 79, Jose Reyes.
And also number 10, Henry Higgins going into the game.
Yeah.
I think you're right, Rob. It's now we're seeing some line play coming into... Yeah.
You know, I like these moves by Levins. He's got to get just a little bit more beef on that line. We're losing the war.
That was a first down by the Eagles, but we called that way before the referees did anyway. We knew that.
We have a nice
10 about the 47-yard line.
So they're going to be in the Blue Devil 47-yard line here.
Yeah, the Blue Devils' defensive line is really going to have to make a stand. We need to see our beef held up. They've got to explode. They've got to use their lower body strength. They've got to neutralize things at the line of scrimmage to allow their linebackers to
snap.
Much better.
There's the pitch to number 89 over the right-hand side. Levins brings him down 2 yards short of the line of scrimmage.
Great job by number 79, Reyes, number 75, Sanders. They did exactly what coach needed them to do, which is just hold that surge at the line of scrimmage. Great job by the Blue Devils on that play, and that allowed Levins to make a
big play. Another good job
of
that play was Ian Osberg, who was covering the end that they split out way to the right, and Osberg recognized that there's no way they're going to throw to him, so he cheated a little bit towards the ball, and that forced the runner to have to cut up field. Brings up a second and 12. 89 in motion, take the snap, fake the pitch, and he is off to the up back. And there's just way too much traffic for him to have to go through. That's another loss of two.
Yeah, and there's our two friends on that play who are stepping up as big as they are. That's Reyes and Sanders doing a job on the inside of that line.
The big man is on the field.
Well, they basically didn't even have to move. All they had to do was wait for the runner to come to them.
No, yep. Yeah, no, I'm liking this. Coach Levins is leaving both of his beef and, leaving his quarter, what do you call that, a double quarter pounder in the game right there?
That's a third and 13. One receiver to the left, one receiver to the right. Now the quarterback's looking to throw. Throws the ball up for grabs pretty much. And it falls down to the earth harmlessly. And who forced that pass early again?
Yeah, that was Levins. But again, I'm just going to keep taking my hat off to the beef in the middle. Because they're just neutralizing the line. And that's a two-minute warning right there.
Two-minute warning for the first half. So it's fourth down and 14 yards to go. And Belchertown is going to take a timeout to think about it. After the timeout, looks like Belchertown is, I don't want to say it. I can't tell if they're going to kick or not.
Yeah, I think so. I think they're kicking here. But it's not clear. You're right.
Fourth and 14.
Matichello's got to get deeper.
I think they're going to kick. They got that big beefy line.
Going for it.
Now they're going to go for it. 89 played the quarterback.
Over the middle. Almost intercepted by number 9, Matthew Campbell.
You know, Rob, that was a Blue Devils got really lucky on that. The Belchertown Eagles did a great job with that play. I'm looking at the referees.
You know, we've seen a lot of balls slide through the hands of receivers. That's got to be slippery out there. I mean, that's about the fourth or fifth ball that we've seen not caught tonight, and I got to believe that's just the moisture of the ball. It's even though it's a fall day, there's some moisture in the air tonight.
A little bit of moisture. That was a great play. They took 89, they're clearly their best offensive player. They had him in kind of this quasi-punt wildcat formation. Osberg takes a snap. There's a pitch to Levins. Brought down pretty quickly. Was that?
I'll bring up second.
It was number 73. So the Blue Devils are at midfield. They got a second and 12 to go.
Again, you know, they had success running Elijah inside early, and they haven't gone to him since.
And we know that we have less than 2 minutes left in the half with the running clock. So here's a tight formation. Osprey takes the snap. There's a handoff to Levins. Looking for that hole on the right. He's got it. There's a flag down. Ball is loose. I think they're going to be calling holding on the Blue Devils, and Belchertown recovered that fumble. That can't be good.
See, are they going to spot it or how they're going to spot it? Spot his knee was down the field.
Holding on the Blue Devils. That's the Klein. Belchertown ball.
Belchertown ball.
Yeah, Levins tried to reach out and get a couple extra yards, and he lost control of the ball. We're starting to see that more and more and more as this game goes on. That ball is obviously tough to hang on to tonight.
Well, we've also seen Belchertown a couple times actually going for the ball. That time looked like they were able to get it loose. sometimes Levens has a tendency to run a little bit too upright, and that ball is a little bit exposed. He's a tall kid. That can happen. So that puts the Blue Devils defense now back in the game, and they have to continue their stellar play so far this half. 42-yard line, 41-yard line. Belchertown starts on their own 41.
About a minute to go in the half.
Two receivers to the left, one to the right. Quarterback in the shotgun. Low snap. He's going to try to run it up the middle himself. Eludes one tackler, runs into his own guy, and then he's finally brought down by, that was number 15. That was Tim Burnish. Good play. It's a gain of five, and there's going to be a timeout called by Belchertown. After the timeout, Belchertown will have a second and five, just shy of the 50-yard line. Time running short here in the first half. They break the huddle.
Second down.
One receiver to the right, three backs in the backfield.
Before the half.
One man in motion takes the snap. This is a quarterback keeper. He's rolling to his right, and Jared Levens has been living off that, helped out by his friend Tyreek Sanders on that one.
You know what? I'll tell you what. Both 75 Sanders and number 79 Reyes have come into this game and really changed the whole feel of the game at the line. They've done a great job.
After a timeout, a big third down play coming up. It's third and 12 for the Belchertown Eagles. One receiver wide left. Was there something you wanted to say, Rob?
No, I think it's closer to 8 yards. I think it's 8 yards to go there.
Quarterback takes a snap, fakes the handoff, rolls to his left. A little bit of a pitch that the receiver couldn't handle.
And he had a whole gaggle of blockers there. Had that been complete, that could have gone for real long.
Well, he kind of like shot putted it to the receiver.
And he unfortunately threw it behind him. And there can't be much time left in this half.
That wasn't as crisp as they would have wanted that to be.
This has to be the last play. I'm guessing this is the last play of the half right here.
Yeah, they're just tight formation. Yeah, they're just going to kneel down?
Yeah, I think so.
No, they're going to hand off. They're rolling to his left. There's the pass. That ball is up, and that ball is completed. I think they fooled us, and they may have fooled the Blue Devils a little bit on that.
Yeah, that was Kessin on the tackle, though. Made a touchdown-saving tackle.
Number 19 for Belchertown reception.
So they're doing a hurry, a little hurry up here. Quarterback takes a snap, and now he clocks it. And they throw the flags. It's going to be a legal procedure. Let's see what the call is. Quarterbacks are huddling up. I call it a legal procedure on Belchertown.
We're confused. They're supposed to be running time in this game, we think, but maybe not. Maybe not the end of the half. I'm not sure.
Number 23 checks in for Hint, Crazy Leg Shaw.
So the referees are talking to the Blue Devil coaches about what exactly happened.
16 seconds left in the half.
16 seconds left. The referee better pick up that flag on the field because it's going to confuse me if it stays there.
Well, our score is still 0-0 here. Great match this afternoon.
Belchertown breaks the huddle. Here they go. There's the snap. Quarterback rolls to his left. And he's met by a bunch of Blue Devils.
That started with Greg Eshevitz. It finished with Hank Higgins. And Jared Levens, Hammer and a Hank on the stop.
Those guys weren't fooled at all on that one.
No.
And there's got to be, we're just kind of waiting for everyone to look at the clock. There we go. That's the end of the first half. Score is 0-0. Start the second half of a 0-0 game. The Blue Devils are going to kick off to the Belchertown Eagles.
That first half was a war, Andrew. There were a couple of key turnovers that prevented a couple of scores. Other than that, it was just a war.
It was fun to watch, that's for sure. I heard Coach Levens talking to his players at halftime, and he said, you know, boys, we're in a dogfight here. And I think he's absolutely right. Osberg getting ready to kick. Checks right, checks left. We're ready to go. There's a kick, low kick. Belchertown had a little trouble fielding it, picks it up finally. This is our friend number 89 doing some damage here so far. That's a gain, return about 20 yards there. They will take over on their offensive duties around the 42-yard line.
Looks like number 23, Griffin Shaw.
Yeah, that was a real nice run back.
Nice run back, and it was an effective kick, too.
It was. You know, those on a night like this, you want to get the ball on the ground. You want it to pick up moisture. It's just tough to handle.
Yeah, it kind of knuckled a little bit through the air, but it didn't really seem to throw him off too much, number 89. Belchertown breaks the huddle, send one receiver wide to the left, one receiver to the right.
Well, they showed, you know, their receivers definitely were open a little bit. Boy, that offensive line is tall.
There's a handoff to number 89, looking to go up the right-hand side. A little bit of a hole, and he gains about 5 yards.
Levins and Greg Gashevitz teamed up on that tackle, it looks like. It's going to bring up second and about 6 yards to go.
And so far, based on two plays so far in the second half, they've both teams have kind of picked up where they left off. It was a pretty fast-paced first half. A lot of action, as you said, a couple of turnovers, one by each team that really stalled effective drives. Belchertown breaks the huddle. Two receivers to the left, one to the right. Quarterback in a shotgun formation. Takes the snap. There's the handoff. Big hole for number 89. He's in the secondary. Then Elijah Davis jumps on his back and finally brings him down after a gain of 12.
And that guy's a real hard runner, don't I? I like the way he runs. Runs in good balance. He runs hard. He finishes his runs.
And he's
nice
leaning
player.
Forward. He's leaning forward while he's running. You know, he's got his momentum going the right way.
Runs downhill.
And seeing Davis tackle him, that's really kind of the heart of this conflict tonight.
It is.
Davis and number 89, I believe his name is Falk. First and 10. Quarterback takes the snap. He's rolling to his left. There's a
fumble,
little bit of an
that's
option.
A fumble.
That is way deep, and it's a loose ball. Followed on by Jose Reyes. Big mistake by the Eagles there, Rob.
You know, they tried to run an option play. I'm not quite sure why they needed to do that.
Forced a turnover. Jose Reyes, but Jets on that feet was right on top of it.
That's a great hustle by 79 Reyes.
That was great hustle.
You know, he's a powerful boy, but he's not necessarily a fast boy, but hustle makes up for a lot there. Boy, his hustle and determination mattered because he easily could have given up on that play. You know, I think Belchertown got out of the comfort zone. There's just no reason for them to run an option play there. They paid the price. They got a little bit outside the box, and unfortunately for them, but fortunately for the Blue Devils, it's first and 10.
And they're going to start with the Wildcat formation. Davis takes the snap, running to his right, cuts back again. Two defenders missed. He's still on his
what
feet.
A run. What a run.
Still going.
What
a one run. Guy to beat. Finally dragged down at the 20-yard line.
What a run.
He gained 15 yards there after you and I both thought he'd been stopped.
You know what? One of the things that's disappointing about this is we don't have the advantage of instant replay, and I'd love to see it. You know what? He had an unintended amazing fake. He slipped as he was going out, and that slipped resulted in him slowing down, allowed big number 78 to over-pursue. He cut it up the middle, and it looks like he broke about five or six tackles. He was not going down.
And that was
what
all
an
after
effort.
All after he did a great job of fielding a low snap.
That's right.
So here we're going to go back to it. Can't blame him for this. Davis in the shotgun formation again. Osberg split wide to the right. Davis takes the snap, and he's just running hard. There's another. He gets down to the 9-yard line there. And there you saw the other thing about Davis that we like so much is that when he knows he's going to get tackled, he's going to make the defender feel it a little bit.
Yeah, and Davis paid the price for that collision. He needs a little bit of break.
A little bit of a break, but those are two outstanding plays by Davis.
Yeah, I don't
know. And it looks like there is a timeout on the field. After successive outstanding runs by Elijah Davis, the Blue Devils have first and goal to go just inside the 10-yard line. Osberg is up under center. He's got a wishbone formation behind him. Takes the snap. There's the pitch to Channel. He's looking for some room on the right-hand side. Cuts it back up. He does manage to gain about 5 yards. 5 yards, but there's a hold, looks like, on the play. Flags are down. The referees are going to talk to each other.
No, it's a chop block.
They're calling a chop block. Still not good for the Blue Devils.
Both still a couple of hamburgers left down there. One or two burgers left.
So that's going to push the Blue Devils back a ways.
Yeah, that's going to bring a first and goal from about the 20.
On a Wednesday with the next storm coming, all ice cream's going to melt. Maybe
the 15-yard, almost.
That's a 10-yard penalty. And it's going to be first and goal from the 20. Well, they like a challenge. Osborne takes the snap. There's the pitch to Levins. Looking for some room. He's got blockers in front of him, and he's got room. One guy to beat who does a great job of slithering in there and cutting his feet out from underneath him. And Levins is shaking up on the play.
Elijah Davis back in the field. Man to watch.
Second down for the Blue Devils on the 15-yard line. Second and goal to go. They were pushed back after a penalty. Osberg wants to check in with the coaches real quick on exactly what the play call is. All right, the offense has themselves straightened out. They know what the play is. We have one receiver out to the left, one to the right. Davis in the Wildcat formation, feeling better.
Second down, Northampton.
There's the snap, looking to run to his right, and he stops. He's looking to throw. Throws the ball up, looking for Osberg. It is knocked down at the 2-yard line. I don't know if Davis should have thrown that ball.
That was in a double coverage. I think there was a much better chance for the Eagles to catch that one than the Blue Devils. And Forte was an ambitious throw. He was under pressure. He threw off his back foot. And he threw in a double coverage.
Crazy Leg Straw is going to be checking out.
It's going to bring up third and about 15.
Third and 15.
Boy,
from
chop,
the 15.
That chop block penalty was really devastating. Camp needs a big play here.
Last gray stream.
I'm looking for a corner pattern 11.
Osberg takes a snap, fakes the handoff to Davis.
Oh,
he's got Fowler in the flat. Fowler, one man to beat, gets down to the 2-yard line.
You know, we were talking about that at halftime. We hadn't seen Fowler in the pass in a pass play, and we really felt like he was poised to make a big play. And sure enough, he comes in. Nice pass by Osberg. Beautiful reception by Fowler. He's 1 yard. Bringing up fourth down. This is a huge, huge, huge play.
And that was also a good play call by the coaches there to use Davis as the decoy there.
Yeah, I like that call. I like the execution. But it's all going to be for naught unless we can punch it in from the one. I think you got to be looking for Davis here.
Blue Devils break the huddle. Here's that Wildcat formation that's worked for him so much.
I don't like this.
Got to
tell
you.
Davis takes a snap. Looking for room on the right.
I like it more now.
There's a flag on the play.
He's in.
He made it in. Davis made it in the end zone, but there's a flag on the play. Let's see what the call is.
That's going to be a first down play. That's a horse collar tackle right there. That's a touchdown.
Touchdown.
Elijah Davis, touchdown.
Blue Devil showed a lot of heart on that drive, Rob.
Wow, that was, you know what, I'm not sure how I felt about that call, but my hat's off to Coach Channel and the coaching staff. It was the right call. You know, I like that shot. I like that Wildcat when the Eagles are more spread out, but on a goal against goal line defense, I'm not as confident. But you know what? The play worked.
A 2-point conversion.
That's
six
why they
points.
Get the big bucks down there, and that's
they
why
do.
We
that's
don't get so much
up here.
For the 2-point conversion try, Osberg is up under center, takes the snap, fakes the handoff, looking to throw. He's got a man
Levins.
Over in the end zone. Levins, just a little bit over his outstretched arms. No good. That makes the score 6-0 Northampton.
You know, Blue Devils have been so proficient on these 2-point conversions all game, and Osberg knows how big they are, and he's a little frustrated with himself. He overthrew Levins on that play. But you know what? He can't be too hard on himself. He made a nice throw to Jared Fowler that set up that touchdown.
Yeah, he also engineered a nice drive to get him down into position to score that touchdown. But that is a big 2-point conversion in a 6-0 game.
Yeah, and I'd really like to see Fowler continue to be used more as a weapon as the second half marches on.
And it looks like they're going to enforce that penalty before the touchdown on the kickoff.
Well, that's just. You shouldn't be able to horse tackle and not face a penalty for that. That was a really horrible tackle.
Sets up.
Hamp will kick off from the 45-yard line of the Belchertown Eagles. Osberg checks to make sure everybody's ready. We wait for the referee's whistle. And here we go. There's the kick. That's a nice kick. Fielded by the Eagles, looking for some room, brings it up the middle,
loose.
Finally brought down around the 24-yard line, where the Eagles will take over on offense.
Looks like number 14, Jared Fowler, and number 15, Timothy Burnish.
Well, there was a lot going on in that play.
Well, I'm just reflecting back on that touchdown. That's a huge score, obviously, in a scoreless game. Gives them the 6-0 lead. Now it's imperative, I think, that they shut them down here.
Yeah, they need to. They need to have an answer on defense. And again, I think the key is going to be those inside quarter pounders. That's Sanders and
Reyes.
Yeah, Sanders and Reyes in the middle there. They are the key. They've been the key so far. They've anchored that line.
Quarterback for Belchertown up under center. Send 89 in motion. There's
nice
the pitch
job.
To 89.
That nice job.
It's deflected. It looked like, was that Sanders who got a hand on that and deflected
I'll
that pitch?
I'll tell you what, they're doing a monster job in there. Both of those guys, they had great penetration. They're putting all sorts of heat on that backfield.
Well, I think, I know I'm not the smartest guy in the room, but even I knew what they were doing there by sending 89 in motion. They were going to do the quick pitch to him. And it looked to me like Sanders made that penetration, got in there, and knocked that ball down. Belchertown was lucky to fall on it.
They sure were.
Yeah, second and 12.
Yeah, you know, and the penetration and that they're showing there on the middle of that line is allowing guys like Levins and Davis to really do some damage around the outside.
So the Belchertown quarterback up under center, 89 in motion again. There's the pitch to him once again. Looking for some room on the right. He's got to cut it back up. Levins misses. He runs into
Osberg and Fowler, I think.
Of Blue Devils, including Osberg and Jared Fowler. That's a good tackle. So that's going to bring up third and 5. And once again, the Blue Devil coaches doing a good job of shuffling players in and out. Situational dependency and also keeping them fresh.
Yep, I think both those guys are getting a well-needed rest, and Garbarini and Gorman are in. Garbarini and Gorman definitely have the speed and the experience, but unfortunately with that big Belchertown line.
Quarterback takes a snap, looking for 89. He cuts up the middle.
Oh.
He's got the first down. He's got some room. Davis wrestles him down after a gain of 10 yards.
First down to Belchertown.
Yeah. You know, Hank Higgins was right there, had a chance to make a play, and unfortunately took a line that was fractionally off. He read the play beautifully and just got out of position just a fraction. That was too bad because Higgins was there to make a play. Such a solid player, almost. He's getting a high five from his coaches.
Their daughter helped make it too.
First and 10 on the 40-yard line. Takes a snap. There's a little pitch to number 89. He looking for some room on the right-hand side. Makes one man miss. Finally brought down by Jared Levins. Looked like there was some motion there, but I did not see a flag.
Yeah,
down.
I agree with you.
There was a lot of movement there.
I thought so too. I thought we were going to see a flag on
our
that play.
Our cameraman is outraged that there's no flag on that one.
Like Canadian football or what? Indoor.
They're going to be going for the Rouge next for Canadian football. It is second and 6. Quarterback takes the snap. There's the pitch to our friend number 89. Looking for Zeru on the left-hand side. Cuts it up. Met by three Blue Devils.
Carey, Fowler, and Burnish.
Fowler and Burnish did a great job of bringing him down. Now, they're calling that a first down.
No,
that looked a little off to me. I don't know quite how that happened. It looked like the referee got confused about what marker was which one over there. But what do I know? I'm just up here in the booth. First down, just shy of the 50-yard line.
I thought he was about a foot or two short from our angle up here, and we're right down the line on that. That's a breath. You know, you can mark, you can measure.
There's a little misdirection there, but Levins sniffs it out.
He's had a fantastic game.
He's been playing a tremendous game today. But one thing about that first down call, I didn't see any of the Blue Devil coaches arguing, so
no. It
must be us. That brings up a second and 11. Tried a little misdirection on that play. Used number 89 as a decoy. Hand off to number 5, going the opposite way. Levins sniffed that out immediately. Shut him down. Yeah. As the clock continues to run here in the second half, each one of these plays becomes more and more important in what we know is going to be a low-scoring affair. Belchertown quarterback takes a snap. He fakes the pitch, looking to keep it himself, finds a hole, and then he was dragged backwards.
And then
backwards
there was no hole. Who got him?
Who dragged him backwards at
the end? I have no idea, but somebody ripped
him down.
We're
going to catch a number on that. That was Fowler.
What a great play. Came out of nowhere. I didn't see him. Did you see him?
No, from where I was looking, all of a sudden the guy started going backwards.
Yeah, you know, he was going forward. It looked like it was going to be a big game. He was down.
Looked like he was on a rubber band or something. Brings up 3rd and 8. And I think this is a big play, Rob.
This is a huge play, but this is 4-down territory, I would say, here.
Well, I'm not so sure about that. I think if you stop them cold here, they got to think about punting. Let's stop them first.
Ooh, disrupted it.
Quarterback fakes the pitch, hands off to the trailing back, and that's a nice play. That's a big gain, and it looks like they're going to call a timeout because they're going to want to, I think they're going to want to measure this one.
Yeah, that's going to be close.
Getting in the Ron Ledoux for Belchertown. Short.
They're calling it 4th down. All right, so now is the big play. 4th and just a half a football, maybe.
You know, again, this is wouldn't be a bad time for Ham to call timeout and bring in the quarter pounders.
Well, I see Reyes is in there. There's the snap. There's the handoff. There's the 1st down. And Moore runs into the welcome arms of Davis. Brought down after a gain of about 4, but that's going to be a 1st down.
That's the end of the 3rd quarter.
That's the end of the 3rd quarter with the Blue Devils leading 6-0. Okay, we're getting ready to start the 4th quarter here at Tugent Field at Smith Vocational High School. And if you were going to say this is a playoff game, what kind of game do we want? This is just the type of game you'd want.
Yeah, this is a big-time game. I mean, each of these teams is earning every yard. I mean, these are big plays. Every play is a big play in this game.
1st and 10 from the Blue Devil 39-yard line. Quarterback takes a snap. There's a pick to bid number 89, who's been doing a lot of damage. Gets into the secondary. Finally brought down by Fowler after a gain of 8. And that's something the Blue Devils are going to have to stop. That's the bread and butter for the Eagles so far. It's a little pitch left, a little pitch right. So far, they haven't gotten a solid answer for that. Blue Devils continue to shuffle players in and out.
Yeah, I like this move, getting 75 Tyreek back in the game. He's just played so well. They've really got it. It's all about that surge at the line of scrimmage. And when we get it, we stop them. And when we don't, we don't.
Another pitch to number 89, looking for some room on the right-hand side this time. Goes into the welcoming arms of Osberg. Brings him down after a gain of 3. That's going to be close to a 1st down. They're calling it.
I'll bring up another Belchertown 1st down.
They gave him a 1st down on that, so it's another 1st down. It was close. I was waiting for the referees to make the final determination. This is a sustained drive here. Someone from the Blue Devils is going to have to step up here and shut them down. The Eagle offense is finally in sync. They start off the game this way, and then they turn the ball over, and then they're.
Wouldn't be a bad time for a turnover, Andrew Shelfo.
I'll see what I can do for you. Quarterback takes a snap. He's looking to pass. And there you go.
Tyreek Wilford with a big stuff, number 7.
That was Gregorshevitz.
Gregorshevitz with the first
Gorman,
hit.
Gorman and Tyreek Sanders.
That's that Gorman surge you were talking about, Robin. Those three defensive linemen surged through and sacked the quarterback to the tune of a 10-yard loss.
You know, there's a long way to go in this game, and certainly Elijah Davis has been the impact player, but you just can't overstate the job that number 79 Sanders and number 79 Reyes and number 75 Sanders have done in this game. And 79 Sanders is
second long here for both.
They're doing a great job out there.
And breaks. So now Gorman, Garbarini, Gregorshevitz really also need to step up as well.
Quarterback takes a snap. There's the pitch to number 88.
Look at the surge.
Call him 89. He's got some room. He's brought down after a gain of about 10, but that really only brings it back to the original line of scrimmage. That makes it 3rd and 10.
You know, I got to give Belchertown a lot of credit. They run those student body left, student body right, and they do a real nice job pulling their linemen. They have a lot of athleticism in their offensive line, and they do a great job getting out on those sweeps. They really do. They pull that guard and going left and right, and he's just super player.
Yeah, and so far the Blue Devils don't have an answer for that one. 3rd and let's call it 10 and a half here on the 25-yard line of the Blue Devils. Takes the snap. There's number 89 right. Looking to the right. Gets past the first guy, and then Levins drags him down after a gain of about 7 yards. That's going to bring up a
here's the play of the game coming up here, Andrew.
This is a fourth and three coming up.
This is the play of the game right here.
I think you're right. They stop him here and take over. It's going to be hard for the Eagles to come back. This is the fourth quarter. Fourth down play in the fourth quarter. This is why all these people paid all this money to come watch this game.
Yeah. The money play. Who's gonna make the play? Is Belchertown gonna make the play or is he?
Quarterback is up under center. Takes the snap. There's the pitch. Looking for his room on his left, and he's going to make the first down. He cuts it back. He's into the secondary. That's a gain of about 7 yards, and that takes him down to the 10-yard line. Like we've been saying, Rob, that's a play that the Blue Devils haven't been able to stop yet.
Only two or three of the things in the top three left, folks. Just a couple.
You know, that was
left. Ice cream is gone.
That was a big time play, and Belchertown came up and rose to the level.
They did what they had to do on that play.
And you feel like they have the momentum. We need a big play here on defense.
First down, fakes the pitch.
There it is.
Tries to cut it back. And the ball's on the ground. It's picked up.
Picked up by number 14.
Fowler picks up the fumble. Runs it back. There's the turnover we were looking for, Rob.
That's the turnover we were looking for. I couldn't see who made that original hit. Was it Fowler? I know Fowler picked it up. Was it Fowler who made the hit and the recovery?
And you know what else happened there? We were just talking about how the Eagles, they had their bread and butter, and they were sticking with it. Then went away from it that time, and look what happened. It was a turnover.
Was that? You know what? That might have been Levins who got in the backfield. That was Levins who got in the backfield there and made that play. That was Ian Levins made that play.
Jared Levins. Tremendous play.
Yeah, brother Ian is on the music very enthusiastically.
That's the play we were looking for, Robert.
That is. You know, Hamp needed, Belchertown had all the momentum. Hamp needed a play. Jared Levins stepped up and made it.
Osberg up under center, takes the snap. There's a hand up the channel, looking for some room on the right. There's the ball on the ground.
He was down. Nope, he was down. Good call. Good call.
The referee on the Belchertown side of the field made that call. And he's probably feeling some stares. And as our astute cameraman points out, that ball looks a little slippery out there.
It is slippery. You know, this is the later it gets, the slipperier it gets, the more the pressure is. I think we can expect to see Davis right, Davis left, Davis up the middle.
Brings up second and 8 on the 32-yard line of the Blue Devils. Osberg takes the snap. There's a pitch to Davis, looking for some room to his left.
Nice block
by
Matty. He cuts
it to the outside. He's going to cut it back up. And he is brought down. I thought the referee was going to reach for his flag on that one because he was tackled up around the head. It was really a gain of only about a half a yard there. That'll bring up third down and 5.
Here's a big play. It comes a big play here. I wouldn't be surprised if we see some Wildcat right here. That seems to be the go-to play on third long.
Yeah, the Eagles did a good job on that play of tracking down Davis. I thought he would break it for a few yards more, but they were able to stop him. We have channel split wide to the left. Osberg takes a snap, hand off to Davis right up the middle, finds a little bit of a hole, and now he's just driving. He's driving. He's close. So he stopped about 2 yards short of the first down. But in a tight game like this, just shy of their 40, they can't risk going for it. They're going to have to punt.
No, this is a punt situation. Well, you know, I'm not sure here. You know, given how hard it is to handle the ball, I don't know. I'm liking a go for it here, and I think Coach Levins agrees. Yeah, I agree with this call here. I don't know if you guys do, but you know, given how hard it is to snap, catch, and punt a ball today.
Big play call up for
him. Hey, there's Osberg. Takes it himself. He's looking to drive, and he is going to be stopped.
And they won't get it. It'll be a turnover on downs. Belchertown will take over. About the 40.
They were stopped about, about a half a yard short.
Yeah, there's just so much strength on the part of the Belchertown line there.
Yeah, not only strength, but they have speed, and they weren't fooled by the quick snap and the quarterback keeper up the middle, unfortunately. There's some discussion there between the coaches and the referees about exactly where the yardage line was marked. That is the first down marker. But the Blue Devil coaches are not going to win that argument.
No, that was the right call. The referee's got it right. Again, it's going to be up to the Blue Devil defense to make a play here. The referees were all over that. I give them credit. I be the first one to pick on them when I think they goof, but I got that right.
No, I think that was not anything the referees had to do with that. It was, I admire the Blue Devil coaching staff for that call. There's a pitch. That's a, was he,
you know,
he
what?
Slipped over his own man.
Levin shoved the offensive player into the runner, tackle him down. That's like a pool play. You see that in billiards right there.
That was the old carom play.
Is that, you know, you don't.
Timeout, Belchertown. After the Belchertown timeout, it's 2nd and 13 on the 42-yard line of the Blue Devils here in the fourth quarter of a 6-0 game. Belchertown quarterback calls the signals, fumbles the snap. I think he fell down on it. Let's wait and see. I hear some optimism for the Blue Devils. Yes! Blue Devils, get
Blue
that
Devils
fumble.
Recovered. Greg Asanis made the right call on that one.
And that was number 70, Gorman, all over that play.
And there's that slippery ball. Once
nice
again,
call,
Rob.
Andy. Great push by the defense here.
That was a huge turnover, Rob.
With the 42. Coming out with a Wildcat.
Davis takes a snap, runs to his right, cuts it back up the middle, and he's brought down, no gain.
That ball's real slippery out there. We can hear from Andrew Kesson, Kesson Productions, observing the slippery nature of the ball, and he got it right. In addition to being, you know, a corporate mogul who is nice enough to donate his entire crew to these film projects, he's also an astute observer of football.
But that slippery ball is going to come into play as this game goes on. And I'm trying to think which team that's going to benefit. Belchertown is feasting off a little bit of misdirection. And that requires handling the ball a little bit more. Let's see what happens.
Hey, why don't we give our sponsors another call out? We've got Northampton Police Relief Association, the Calvin Coolidge Nursing Home, Angelic Builders. We've got Pioneer Landscapes and MRW Connected, Liquors 44, Mark Tanner, Osberg & Associates, Florence Savings Bank, The News. We've got Collective Copies and Newman's Construction. We got Goggins Real Estate and Joe's Pizza, Whalen Insurance, and the Dove Business Associates.
2nd and 10.5 for the Blue Devils. Osberg takes a snap. He's looking to throw. Rolls to his left. He's going to have to set his feet to throw it. He gets the ball away. Channel in his hands. I couldn't tell if 21 of the Belchertown Eagles knocked that away a little bit. That was a tough throw by Osberg. He managed to get it away and put it right on Channel's hands.
Yeah, you know, again, I got to say this. You know, Matty's in a position he doesn't usually play. That's Braden's position. He had an opportunity to make a play there. And, you know, that's just not the strength of Matty's game. We also have Valley Home Improvement, Weber and Grinnell Insurance, the Blue Bonnet Diner, and Strides. I also want to thank family sponsors, the Morrisons, the Benedizeks, the Berensons, the Zinals, the Tudorins, and the Burnishes.
Brings up a 3rd and 10.5 to go here, and Osberg takes a snap. There's a pitch to Channel, looking for some room on the right, and that's not going to go anywhere.
Modine and Eckler is going to be a loss for Northampton now.
And there's a timeout on the field. After Channel takes the pitch to his right for a 2-yard loss, the Blue Devils are in punt formation. There is approximately a little over 2 minutes left in the fourth quarter here. So I think this is a good play.
You know,
I know because I heard the referee say there was 3:25 left a little while ago.
It's time to congratulate Andy. I want to congratulate all the Blue Devils. Christopher Rosenthal, number one. I want to.
Elijah Davis.
Here's the kick.
That is blocked. That's a live ball. Belchertown falls on it. They recover at the 28-yard line of the Blue Devils. That is a horrible series of play for the Blue Devils.
It started with a drop pass and then an unsuccessful run and a blocked punt. Those are just three plays that fortunately didn't work out real well for the Blue Devils. But
that's offsides on the Belchertown Eagles.
We're bailed out on a flag. That is a huge play. We'll have an opportunity to kick again. That will not bring up a first down, but it'll give us another opportunity to punt. You know, one thinks that maybe that offsides is the reason why they were able to get in the backfield there.
That's our story. We're going to stick to it. So from 5 yards closer, we're going to try the punt again. Elijah Davis takes the snap. There's the punt. Someone got a hand on it, but he gets it away. It is fielded. Ball to the ground. And the Blue Devils fall on it.
What a great play Matt Channel made. Matty Channel redeems himself with a monster hit. Oh, you can hear that up here.
Channel, first one down the field.
And runs right into the receiver who fumbles the ball. Channel. You know, we talked about Matt not being the strength of his game, but that is the strength of his game. The guy's a wicked hitter. He's played a great safety all year. He's a hell of a tackler. He showed it there. He stepped up for the Blue Devils. They needed to play. Channel makes it. Blue Devils take over first and 10 late in the game. Hey, let's give a shout out to number 2, Eamon Powers. Number 3, Cyrus Harry. Number 6, Jose Ortiz. Tange Bader.
Osper takes a snap. There's a handoff to Davis. He is wrapped up at the line of scrimmage, but it's important to remember that at this point, we're more interested in keeping that clock moving. And there is a timeout, a 30-second timeout for Belchertown.
Hey, we gotta give a shout-out to Jack Reed, number 9, Matt Channel, Hank Higgins, number 10, number 11, Ian Osberg, and number 12, Jeffrey Parsons, Julius Ney, Jared Fowler's number 14 has had an amazing year. Timmy Burnish steady every week. Josh Rivera, you know, the aircraft carrier for this team. Elijah Davis, newcomer Joey Brosna had a super year. Griffin Shaw has made big play after big play this year. Javante, great, dominant defensive player, 11s. No messing with Kesson, number 34. Ryan Braden, 40. Solly Berenson, solid inside player, number 56. Nick Sandoval. And, you know, I got to tell you, Nick's absence tonight has really been felt on the line. You know,
yeah,
we haven't really talked about that all night long, but he really probably could have been the difference maker on this offense. Number 68, Andy Gregashevitz. Will Guzman. Number 7, Ethan Gorman. 72, Bo Gardner-Barini and Tyreek Sanders and Jose Reyes.
Osper takes a snap. There's a handoff to Levins, cutting back across the formation. No gain. That'll bring up a third and about 11.
With a moving clock. And we're looking at the officials.
And also, Rob, I want to take the opportunity to thank you for the hard work you've put into the booth over the last few years.
There's nothing hard about the work that we do. This is great fun. And doing
don't say
it,
that.
And doing it with a talented guy like Andrew Schelfo.
And there's the two-minute warning.
Makes it even more enjoyable. And again, we've talked about him often. We've talked about him tonight. But for the generosity and skill of Kesson Productions and Andrew Kesson, none of this would happen.
Third and 12. Osprey takes the snap. There's the fake handoff. He throws the ball up. It is in and out of the hands of Fowler. Now, I don't know about that play, Rob. Do you want the clock to be moving?
I'm not sure it stops the clock, though, does it, at this level?
Let's see. Looks like they're keeping the clock moving. Okay, then I can get on board with that.
Yeah. You know, but for the fact that the clock always moves, I would agree with you. And he had Fowler there. The ball, I think, hung up there a little bit too long. And I think that part of the reason for that is he was forced to throw off his back foot because of the pressure that was put on by the defense. Yeah.
Fourth down.
Thank you, Crazy Leg Shaw.
We know there's under 2 minutes left in the game. Blue Devils are going to go for it. They're on the 35-yard line of the Eagles. There's the hard count. Osper takes the snap. There's a pitch to Davis, looking for some room in the left. He's dragged back.
And he just gets back to the line.
Brought down after a gain of about 2 yards. That's going to leave them short of the first down. So they're going to turn it over on downs to the Eagles. This game ain't over yet.
No, it's not. There's a long way to go.
The Pewater Eagles, 78, Brad Taft.
Our eyes are on the officials. We are looking for somebody to give us some indication of the time. There's got to be under 2 minutes to go. 142, 143. If I saw a 1, a 4, a 3.
All right, we're getting better at this time thing. Eagles are going to take over on their own 33-yard line, and we certainly have seen some explosiveness in this offensive unit.
You know, we talked about it all year long. You know, this play starts at the line, and our line has really stepped up to today's game. But ultimately, cornerbacks Osberg and Kesson are going to need to make a play here. And Matty Channel, experienced safety back there. You know, we're looking for Matty Channel to make another game-saving play here, and they have trips left, so Matty's got to pay attention to that because there's an overload on the left side.
Quads left, and there's a flag because that's an illegal formation. and they had 12 men on the field. That's how you can do four receivers to the left, one to the right, and one in the backfield with the quarterback. That's not the way if you're Belchertown. You want to start what could be the last drive of your season.
I'll make it first and 15.
Well, let's hope that this is their last drive of the season right here. And again, we have that's a stack. Okay, so we've got coverage on the left.
All right, we got three receivers to the left, one receiver to the right. Back
fumble,
the
there's a fumble.
A botched snap. Quarterback picks it up. He's running. He's got some room. And he's dropped after a gain of 13 yards. That's going to make him a yard short of first.
That's a great play by Fowler. You know, Osberg needs to do a better job with his balance on that play and come up and make that play.
And that's the Belchertown version of the Wildcat there. I don't know if that was supposed to be a run. He picked up the botched snap and turned it into quite a play.
And
second
we've got
two.
Double coverage. We got two out here on the right.
There's the
and
snap.
Looking
he's
right.
Looking to throw. And he eludes one would-be tackler in Davis. Now he's off to the races. He's brought down by Gorman, but not until he already picked up the first down.
Did a great job of getting the Blue Devils.
But again, we'll give up the first downs as long as we keep that clock going.
Yeah, this is the Blue Devils version of the prevent defense.
Belchertown going with the no huddle. And they clock the ball. So that brings up the question that I have to ask after being chastised before. Why does that stop the clock, but the incomplete pass not stop the clock?
Under 2 minutes. It might be able to stop the clock under 2 minutes.
So production manager and corporate mogul Kessin gave us a good interpretation of the time.
I'm not saying I couldn't come up with a reason why. I'm just trying to figure out what the real reason why is.
Our guess is in the last 2 minutes that the clock stops on some plays and not others.
Here, if I'm not mistaken, folks, can't lead this match.
30 seconds left in the game. 50 seconds left in the game.
Second and 10. Blue Devils D here. Belchertown sends one receiver to the left, two receivers to the right. Quarterback takes a snap. It's a keeper up the middle.
Burnish and Gorman. Gorman, another big tackle.
You know, I like that play call. If he had been a little bit faster, that might have been done some real damage. So that brings up a third down and 5 yards to go.
And the clock is ticking.
Clock is ticking. And that looked like that was motion on that one, looked like to me.
We're not quite sure we understand that because that brings up a fourth down and about five.
Well, I think part of it might be is that Belchertown, they haven't been using their regular quarterback. They're using number 88 there as the quarterback, and he may not be as familiar with what he's supposed to do. Because that brings up fourth down, fourth and five.
You know, Belchertown, if they don't convert here, that this game is over. So this is a do-or-die play for the Eagles.
Well, I'm looking for a quarterback keeper here. There's no way he's going to throw that ball.
And here comes the throw.
Throws the ball. That ball is up in the air. There's a man open. That was almost a David Tyree catch. They're calling that a catch. He got that off of his helmet, Rob.
Number five for Belchertown, Clayton Gaskin, a huge first down. Big catch.
I don't quite see how he could catch that ball without having to touch the ground. But the referees made that call. And now they spike it again.
Spikes the ball and shut the clock down.
And I have to say, among the other shocking things going on, I'm shocked that we actually saw a team run out of timeouts.
25-yard line.
I have no idea how he caught the ball either. I don't know. I don't know if he did, but in the ref's eyes, he did.
Referee was right in front of the play was right in front of the ref.
The movement, but then they have time.
But I don't know how he managed to do it without having that ball hit the ground. I know I shouldn't say that around here, but that was a very David Tyree-like catch. It looked like he caught it off of his helmet.
He sure did, and, you know, Osberg had a chance to make a play there and just came up a fraction short, and the Belchertown player made the play, keeping his team alive on a desperation fourth down play.
So now it's second and 10 on the 25-yard line of the Blue Devils. Two receivers to the right, two receivers to the left. They're in this Wildcat formation. Quarterback takes the snap. It's a bad
fumble.
Snap. It's past him. Levins has a chance to break him down. That's a 21-yard loss. There's that slippery ball again.
It sure is, and unfortunately.
And the clock is still going. So
and that's
then,
the ball
there's
game.
The game. Wow, that was just a tremendous
game.
Blue Devils hold on to win 6-0.
You know, I got to congratulate this Belchertown team. They played tough all game long. What a war.
And the next game for the Blue Devils. Devils will be in the Super Bowl next weekend. Let's say good luck to the Blue Devils. Thank you, Rob.
Thank you, Andrew, and thank you, Kesson Productions.
Final score, Blue Devils 6, Belchertown Eagles 0.